Have you ever found yourself scrolling endlessly, even when you don't want to? Do you notice that your focus is going down? Maybe you even have thought to yourself that you have adult ADHD? Well, in today's video, I'm going to share with you why you keep going back for scrolling and how it's impacting your focus, your concentration, your organization, and your ability to stay motivated. I'm going to explain to you the neuroscience behind screen addictions, and most importantly, what you can do to regain control of your brain and get back to feeling pleasure and happiness in your life. I'm Dr. Trish Lee, welcome back. Today we're talking about infinite scrolling, the habit loops that keep you stuck in it, and what you can do to break free. So if you're ready to regain control of your brain and get back on purpose in life, you're in the right place. Let's get started. Apps train your brain to expect constant stimulation. This keeps you going back for more, whether it be drama, violence, or explicit matter. You're used to high levels of stimulation from the screen, but that can make your life pale in comparison. They're very dopamine-rich activities, and they're screen-based. Seeking and scrolling itself is a dopamine activity. And of course, what you watch matters too. Your brain isn't broken. You're just training it to go back to the rewards where it seeks the highest level of pleasure from dopamine. Neuroplasticity is not selective. That's why I always say it can be your best friend or your worst enemy, depending upon how you train it. It works in this way. If you like to watch car crash videos, which are very highly stimulating, they will produce a lot of dopamine in your system. So basically, car crash videos become your pleasure source. Now your guitar lessons and playing your guitar that you used to love to do, it can't compare. There's not enough dopamine compared to a car crash video. It's a super normal stimulus, very high dopamine. So where the problem lies, so does the solution. The solution is to train your brain for healthier pleasure sources, not in the screen. Take a break from your screen time. You will find that this happiness hack will go a long way. Come out of the screen and get back to doing those activities that you love. Learn to balance it. My son Seamus, who used to be a hardcore gamer, he's learned with my help to take breaks from gaming with his friends and instead play pickleball, the most popular sport since COVID. I think he's in his room, but he's not. He's up at the court with his friends, enjoying his real life. If you want to figure out how to come out of the screen and get back to enjoying your real life, please go to drtrishlee.com. The link is in the description, where you can download my free guide, Reward Reset. There's 32 brain hacks there that can show you how to come out of the screen and reclaim your life. Every time you check your phone, whether there's a notification there or not, you're training your brain to be distracted. In this way, many people think that they have developed adult ADHD. I call it screen excess ADHD or screen-induced ADHD. There's a very large study in the Journal of American Medical Association of 2,587 people. That's a lot. And it showed that these teenagers, the more they were on their screen, the more they experienced ADHD. Difficulty organizing, attending, focusing, also hyperactive behaviors because you need constant overstimulation. So I want you to know your focus isn't gone. It's just being trained out of your brain. But that means that you have the ability to train it back. ADHD in and of itself is a neurodevelopmental disorder, which means that you had it before the age of 12. So if you're struggling with ADHD symptoms, it's likely that it's from your screen time. We know from science that the average attention span in the year 2000 was 12 seconds, and screens were impacting that, to be honest. Now it's less than 8 seconds. The attention span of a goldfish is 9 seconds. So if you feel like you have less attention than that goldfish, your screens are playing a part. So what's the solution? Your happiness hack for right now is to do the deep work. Think deeply. Spend at least 90 minutes in concentration and focus on something that you love or you care about. Now, I want you to know, if you're used to seeking and scrolling and dopamine hits from social media, 90 minutes is a really long time. So start small and build up incrementally. The way you can do it is by starting to focus until it feels uncomfortable. Go just a little bit beyond that and then add a minute at a time. Okay, you don't have to quit your screens entirely, but you do have to manage and balance them. You can use the 90-second rule to do that, but remember that it's important to also take breaks from concentration. There's a big study on optimal productivity that shows that 90 minutes of focus with a 15-minute break can be the way that you can tap into unlimited productivity. But remember, during those breaks, no screen time, because now most of us work in deep concentration on a screen. It's important to give your brain a break from screens in these breaks. Okay, so if you want to fast track your focus recovery, please reach out to my team at Dr. Trish Lee and Company. We specialize in using technology that can, first of all, see if you have that ADHD pattern in your brain, and then help to rewire it using advanced technology. We also offer coaching strategies like the ones that you're receiving here in these videos. So please click the link in the description and schedule a consultation. Okay, so let's recap. You're going to get the happiness trifecta from your real life, and to improve your focus, you're gonna stay away from the constant distraction of your phone or your technology. You're going to do the deep work for 90 minutes at a time, taking 15-minute breaks away from screens. In this way, you're going to improve your focus, your concentration, your productivity, and you're gonna feel better than ever. If you want more help, click the video on the screen now so we can spend more time together and I can show you how to improve your focus coming away from the screen. And as always, remember, control your brain or it'll control you.